dabble for a while.
There's going to be a blooper reel.
I'm sure there is going to be a blooper reel. You're to the left, but you're on the right. But you didn't set up the right way, because the desk is not, it's obviously not centered. No, I'll move the desk. Here, look, move the desk.
Or just move a little bit
more. Or maybe you should,
move a little more to the left so that there's equal.
Maybe you should stop
It's complaining. Recording.
Exactly, that's why. This is banter.
This is okay. What's called banter.
No, look, you're really over there. I'm like more, Okay.
Hi, this is CINEASTE Meets West. I'm Kyle Turner.
I'm Joe Brady. He's CINEASTE.
And he's a wasp.
Hey, that's not insulting. It's just, what'd you call it?
Why Anglo-Saxon Protestant? It's
that's
not,
me.
It's not that uncommon. It's actually pretty fun. Okay.
I know.
This is the first episode of what we hope will be a relatively long-running vlog or video podcast where we discuss films.
You're looking at the thing, right? At the screen? Because you have to be looking slightly to the left if you're looking at the screen.
I wasn't looking anywhere because when I talk, I just...
Yes.
There's going to be a blooper reel, obviously.
I think we can keep this all in. This is good stuff.
So, we will be talking about...
Uncensored.
I don't know if we can do uncensored.
We should definitely do uncensored.
We will be talking about... We'll be talking about film culture, stuff that we really love.
I'm basically just here to get him off track, as you can see already.
He's very good at it. We've known each other for 4 years. So why don't you start with your introduction?
Okay. Well, I'm Joe Brady. I've always go to KB Academy. That's this kid here. My love of film kind of started when I was really young, when I first watched Chitty Chitty Bang Bang with Dick Van Dyke when I was about 5 years old. My mom, yes, I know it's not a good thing to talk about, but oh, he's gonna take notes on how bad I. Oh, he ripped his arms off. I bought him this fancy thing. Look at it's a guy that you like to take the pen through the sticky notes. I don't know, like, right? Anyways, judging you. Judging him. Yeah, he's judging me. I don't know if you can see that, but it says he's judging me. So it started with my love of film with him, because I realized that I like to watch films over and over. None of my friends or relatives like to ever do that, and I really always liked watching films over.
He has rigor mortis.
He's shriveling up and dying. I like to watch films over and over, and I really found myself discovering new things every time. And I loved watching directors' commentaries, and I had all these tics of a cinephile, but I hadn't quite, learned what that was yet, or that was a thing, or a niche that I... Don't make the cat go away! Rain Man's a nice cat. His cat's name's Rain Man, yeah. Judge him for that. Anyways,
Wrong sticky note.
Yeah, I know, it's a wrong sticky note. Okay, but yeah, so, I hadn't really, realized my full film love until I went to high school and met this guy who was already a certified cinephile.
The first time that I met him, he was talking about The Departed by Martin Scorsese.
My favorite film at the time, and it's still really up there. It was the first film that really got me into movies, because I realized there was so much to it, and I loved it unconditionally.
And I think before I even said hello to him, I just rattled off all the various IMDb information.
I was like, wow, this kid's fucked up. No, I'm kidding, no. I'd never really met anybody before that liked movies the way I did. I thought I was just an anomaly. And people online that I didn't actually know. But, so we kind of talked about film for a long time after that, but he really helped me solidify my love for film. And, I wasn't really looking at it very analytically before. I thought I was, but I had no idea the scope of things that go on in movies that I do now. We went to an MCC class together, or a community college class, last year, and that was a lot of fun. It really helped me realize what film's about and why I enjoy it the way I do. I had a longer journey through high school for film than this guy has here, because you loved film before you came to high school, and you knew that. Mm-hmm. I wasn't as, strong-minded with it, and you helped me a lot with that. So I owe a lot of my present knowledge that I'll be discussing, mm-hmm. or hopefully discussing here, to him, so I appreciate that. But, that's my background. It's more of just I'm an amateur film lover. And Netflix is my best friend.
Everyone's an amateur film lover here.
Yeah, we're not professionals. But we like to think we are. He mostly does. He knows bigger words than I do, so.
That fine. Means nothing. Okay, so. I fell in love with film at a very early age. I'm not actually entirely sure when exactly, but while other kids grew up watching films of the Disney Renaissance, I grew up watching films like Bringing Up Baby, Arsenic and Old Lace, What's Up Doc, mostly screwball comedies, but Young Frankenstein, etc.
Hey, not just that Disney movies are bad. I grew up on those, and I turned out okay.
I'm not saying that they're bad, it's just that I watched other things when I grew up. And I started realizing my interest in film maybe in second grade, because every even meager assignment that we got, I tried to spin it to film. And around fourth grade, I said that I wanted to become a film historian. Everyone made fun of me. They thought it was really stupid. They thought it was about...
I wouldn't make fun of you.
They thought it was a fat guy sitting on a couch smoking. That always ticked me off, but...
Weed.
No, just nicotine cigarettes, or a pipe, like a sir. Oh.
Go on.
Yeah, so I always had an interest in film. I always begged to watch movies. My dad had an account, a membership with Hollywood Video, which is now defunct. And we would go and get like 3 movies a weekend. And then I fell in love with the Criterion Collection in 8th grade. All my Criterions are here.
I only have 3. He's kind of up on me.
I've got like 94.
Bastard.
Got 94.
It's 94. I only have 3.
I've got like 94. Anyways, the introduction to the Criterion Collection exposed me to world film. And I get that it's a little Eurocentric, but... I still find it interesting. And from jumping off of the Criterion Collection, I've discovered more films on Netflix, etc. And I'd like to become a professional film critic. I've had my film review blog since 2005, and I write essays on film for fun. Like, I'll just bang out...
I read them for fun.
I'll just bang out, like, a 2,000-word essay in a night when I should be doing homework, which might explain my biology grade.
Well, I forgot to include that my dad also really helped get me into film, too. When I was a kid, my parents got divorced when I was, like, 10. And that, in a weird way, that actually started me on film, because I would go to his house and we'd have nothing at all to do. So we just watch movies. And he was a huge lover of Quentin Tarantino. And he really started me on him, too. And I love him. He was one of those parents that didn't really let me watch a lot of stuff. My mom was that parent. My dad would talk about movies at his house, and then I would go to my mom's and ask to watch the movies. And usually she'd let me watch them, but 2 years after they got divorced, when I was like 12, we would start going to Newbury Comics and buy a couple used DVDs every weekend, or every other weekend when I was with him. I had a rule, I could find whichever 3 I wanted to find that he said were okay, relatively okay. And they got, you know, progressively higher ratings or lower ratings, whatever you would go with that, as time went on. But they had to be like $10 or less from like the wicked cheap section, so that was a fun activity we did together. But now I've completely surpassed him in film love. The minute he said he didn't like Drive or Black Swan, our relationship was pretty much completely over in that aspect.
Yeah, we sometimes alienate our friends.
Oh, sometimes?
All the time.
All the time. Most of our friends have no idea what the hell we do on the weekends and don't honestly give a shit anymore. But I also work at a movie theater. I work at the one in Manchester. This is Connecticut, by the way, those who don't know.
We live in Connecticut.
Yeah, we do.
Boring old Connecticut.
Hey, you live in boring old Connecticut town. I live in okay Connecticut town. But, yeah, I work at a movie theater, and so I can give some insight on stuff going on there, which is kind of cool. Working there has been really cool for me. I get to see free movies whenever I want, which is really cool. So I get to see a lot more, you know, in theater movies, which we will discuss recent films in another. And wait, now? Do you want to do that now? That's next.
5 favorite movies.
Recent movies. No. Yes, favorites go at the end, Kyle.
But we're, as part of our bracket, we're doing our 5 favorite films.
No. I don't like that, because 5 is too little. We both have lists of 100s, okay?
But just as, to give the audience a taste, okay. what are just 5 off the top of your head? They don't have to be...
Off the top of my head, these are not in any particular order, but currently, right now, Django, Departed, Sweeney Todd, American Psycho. How many is that? 4?
Yeah, can we get, like, the full titles and directors?
Oh, okay. Sorry, guys. Currently, American Psycho by Mary Harron, which I read the book for as well, and blew my brains out awesome. Love it. The Departed by directed by Martin Scorsese, starring Leonardo DiCaprio and Matt Damon and Jack Nicholson and Mark Wahlberg, which I still don't understand that Oscar at all. He's awesome, but I don't get that nomination particularly. Sweeney Todd, The Demon Barber of Fleet Street, directed by Tim Burton, starring Johnny Depp, Helena Bonham Carter, and greatly Sacha Baron Cohen, whom I love in that movie, but not much in anything else. Except Borat, which he's pretty good at. What else right now? Oh, Shame, directed by Steve McQueen, starring Michael Fassbender and Carey Mulligan. I have the Hunger Criterion, one of the three that I have. Is that four? So that's three so far. I don't like this, but... and then I could probably say any of the Tarantino films currently that I could just list off, but let's go with Pulp Fiction, because I watched it today, again, directed by Quentin Tarantino, written by Quentin Tarantino, starring a bevy of stars, among which are Samuel Jackson, John Travolta, and then five, I gotta throw something foreign in there, or else you're gonna show me up completely. I don't watch many foreign films, not because I don't want to, I just don't. I don't know. I don't have time. I do have time. I just don't.
That is a lie.
I know it's a lie.
It's fine. I like listening. It's not a bad thing.
I like listening to words. So, for foreign-wide, let's just throw in Holy Motors, which I saw recently and thought was fan-effing-tastic. So, yeah, that's my five currently.
Who's it directed by?
Leo Carra, right?
Leos Carra, I think.
Leos? Is it Leo or Leos?
It has an S on it.
Carra. Okay. And starring Denis Levant. Or Denis Levant, or whatever fucking French way he pronounces his name. So that was five. And that is in no way the scope of my entire film, whatever.